Bye. shows in this city, and we're going to make sure we do ourselves proud. And in New York. So let's have a great time tonight if we can.
Wow.
of America in late August 1970, and I played a club in Los Angeles called the Troubadour Club. My career kind of quickly took off after that, and I was so thrilled to be an American, because that's where all the great music had come from that I heard in my life. And so America was the first place that I actually sold any records, and the first place that I became well known. So I'm so grateful for that. Thank you. I had an album called the Elton John album, coinciding with my visit to the Troubadour. And the first single from that album was the song that I'm going to play now, and it was recorded by Aretha Franklin. At that time, having anything recorded was a bonus. But Aretha Franklin, I mean, Bernie and I could not believe it. I was lucky enough to meet Aretha Franklin in my lifetime. I was lucky enough to sing with her, record with her. And she did her last ever concert at St. John the Divine for the Elton John AIDS Foundation when she was so ill. But those who were there will never forget it, because it was absolutely soul-destroyingly good. Bless our heart forever. This is the song. Well, in Moselle, I have never knew. I've seen a specter, he has been there too. Thank you. band who don't see me. I know that Dan Welch came out in the early 70s. This song is like Danny went Crocodile Rock on it. This is not Danny went Crocodile Rock. This is a song featuring our guitarist David Johnson. And it's called Have You Mercy on the Criminal.
Say hello.
next song comes from one of my favourite albums that we recorded called Captain Fantastic and the Band of Cowboy. And the reason I love that album is because all the songs were about Bernie and I and how we struggled to make it as songwriters, all the disappointments we came across, all the doors that were shut in our face, and how we had to persevere and try as hard as we could. And eventually, as you know, it succeeded. The song is one of my favorite songs that I've ever written, and it's called Someone Save My Life Tonight.
Bye. I'm
Goodbye, Mama. Though I never knew you, Lord, how the grave holds you, sir, with those around the floor. Pull out of the woodwork, and they whisper, deep breath, and I say, I'm a traitor, and they made you change your name. And it seems to me you lived your life like a candle in the wind, never knowing who to quench when the rain set in. And I would like to know you, but I'm just a kid. Your candle burned out long before religion ever did. Loneliness is tough, the toughest role you ever played. I'm a creative superstar, and pain was the price you paid. Even when you died, all the prayers still have you. All the prayers left to say will the mountain to summon the moon. And it seems to me you lived your life like a candle in the wind, never knowing who to quench when the rain set in. The world like to know, but I'm just a kid. Your candle burned out long before you let you know. Goodbye, Normandy. Though I never knew you, Lord, how the grace holds you, sir, was all around the world. Goodbye, Normandy. From the young man, 22nd row, we see you as nothing more than sexual, more than just out of Maryland, Monroe. And it seems to me you lived your life like a candle in the wind, never knowing who to cling to when the rain set in. I would like to know you, but I was just a kid. You candle burned out long before you mentioned it.
Yes.
This band I have right now is very special to me. They're the most incredible musicians. They're just locked in every night. So I want to introduce them one by one to every one of you. And you've got them in the big Madison Square Garden Hall, please, okay? Let's hear it. Shows together, just him on percussion and me on piano and vocals. He came to New York with some TM dates. And it was one of the most wonderful things I've done as a musician, because it was just the two people on stage. It was scary. But I learned a lot, and I've never forgotten him. And he's played with everybody there is to play with on stage and on record. On percussion, the amazing Ray Cooper! He's lasted the distance, and it's been a long time, 52 years. But I can't think of anybody I'd rather have on drums and vocals than Nigel Elton! Yeah. then I wanted to add a different sound to the band, and I wanted a guitar, so I thought of David Johnson, who played on the Madman Across the Water album on acoustic guitar. And was in a sort of group called Magna Carta, and he played banjo, mandolin, and everything. And, but he hadn't picked up an electric guitar till he joined us on the Honky Chateau record. And obviously he's never looked back since then. He's my band leader. He gets everything together with the guys in LA for me. He's got his own album out called Deeper Than My Roots, which is a really wonderful album with his family. From Edinburgh, Scotland, on guitars and vocals, David Johnson! Except when they come up here on stage. We're very careful because we want to get this show done. We want to get a tour done, so we're being very rigorous. But it means that we can't meet people, our friends who come to see us in every city. And of course in New York, we have so many friends that we can't see, so I'm going to bear with me. Mention them on stage. I'd like to say hello to Ray Dariano and his wife, Laurie Rothman, Robin Patrick, Kevin McCullum and Satan Toe, Frank Kurz, my publicist, Frank Moorbach, Jenny Whiteside, and Gretchen, I love you all. Chris Page and Rebecca, all the way from England, and the wonderful Anoush Manoukian. Thank you all for coming. So sorry I couldn't say hello to you in person. All right. Today, two musicians have died. I'm going to dedicate this song to one tonight and one tomorrow, because I want them each to have their own little spot. Gary Brooker used to be in a band called the Paramounts, and when I was 16, I used to go and watch them at a local venue, and I loved it because he was the first person I saw play electric piano, and he then formed a group called Purple Horror. And well, Why Does Shade Pale For Me is the record that reminds me of the 60s more than any other record. It gets you, hear it and you go, ah, the 60s. An amazing song, an amazing people player, amazing vocalist and writer. I want to dedicate this song to him because he was just out of the ordinary. And no one played and wrote like him. Gary Brooker, God bless you. R.I.P. This is for you.
Set my heart on the line. Bye. I'm gonna make it.
something to look better, baby. Just pop sand to me. Come on now. Thank you. First time I played in New York was at the Fillmore East on the 20th of November 1970 with Liam Russell. Tonight is the 190th show on the Farewell Yellow Road Show. And this is my 71st show at Madison Square Garden. And it's my 114th show in the New York area. So, as you can see, I love playing in New York. But I want to say to you, this is my favorite venue in the world. I have so many incredible memories of this place. Thanksgiving 1974 with John Lennon is one of the greatest memories of my life. The concert for 9/11 was heartbreaking. And I don't know, they were going to move this building at one point. That would have been a disaster because you can't move an atmosphere and you can't move history. And I would like to say thank you to everyone in the audience. Somebody is 170 shows you've been to. Unbelievable. You've been so loyal to me. I'm an Englishman who's loved playing in America. I love this country. It's given me so much. I've had the most wonderful life. And after this tour is finished, I'm going to spend time with my family, my children, and enjoy the rest of my life. And thank you for understanding. I love you so much. I wish you all love, happiness, prosperity, and thank you for everything you've given me.
When are you gonna come down? When are you going to land? Should I feel the fall? Should I listen to my demand? You know you can't hold me for real. Since I love you, a dark present for your friends to open. Boys too young to miss.